Mr. Smith being great. He is a man that has impressed every individual he's come about. Of course, he has had his own way of doing things, and we all have our own way of doing things. But that which we do, we desire to please other folk, other people. So I fervently believe I will go forth and say that a man of greatness, and he is a man of honor. Some say, why would you say he's a man of greatness? He didn't have a lot of money. He didn't have great things to give unto folk. But what he did have within his greatness, what he was able to change the heart and mind of people. And why would you say he deserves some honor? Because he kept his mouth quiet. But most importantly, when you saw him, you knew exactly how to handle him. You handle him with the love that he honestly deserved. In other words, he taught Annapolis City how to love and how to care for one another. Whenever you see him across the street, he has his own way of doing things. We all have our own way of doing things, but my understanding is that if you do it your way, is it showing love and compassion for everyone that we meet? So whenever we saw him, we thought about the love, and we thought about the compassion. And most importantly, when you talk about love and compassion, you can't help but to think about the God that created him. I'm not trying to preach, but I'm trying to let you know some things about Carlester. Whenever you saw him, you didn't realize the fact that I'm looking at someone that God had created, because I see the love and compassion in his heart, and I've got to do something to let everybody know who he is. So therefore, some had went forth and gave unto him. They just departed some riches and some cares and concerns unto him, all the way to a point someone thought it necessary and privy to paint a mural of him within the Napa City. Isn't that something? Turn my horn off. You want to drive my car down the street? So I'm not a turn this thing off. I'm sorry. Amen. But he was a man of respect. Some say he didn't have to say too much, and sometimes it's best not to say a lot at all. But you know, even in his presence, he did not have to say a word at all. Folk went about and they were so overly concerned about him, he didn't want no one to bother him. You mess with him, you're messing with Annapolis City. Now, go farther and say, you know, everyone has a form of greatness tucked deep down inside of them. If we allow that particular type of greatness come out of us, everyone will be able to see the beauty that God created us in. Everyone has a particular form of beauty. But how can that beauty come forth if you do not allow yourself to love and show compassion to anybody? Whenever I saw him walking up and down the street, I said, how can I show my love and compassion for him? And one voice said, Kevin, just tell everyone else about him. Just show that you're concerned about him. He's going to be just fine. God took care of him. All the way to a point he blessed his sister to do a great and marvelous and wonderful thing. I'm not trying to preach, but I gotta let some things know. How is it possible that we love one another, even in our families, and don't want to take care of them? Allow them to live out on the street and say, I love you so much, brother, but you gotta stay over there on that side because I don't have room in my house for you. But let's go ahead and make everything simple, more and more simpler. He was a man that lived in Annapolis City. I'm reminded of him when we were growing up. But as time progressed on, of course, life responsibilities tore me away. But coming back, he was a man, just an ordinary man. But guess what? He had a great lot of respect by other people. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. I'm not here to speak, but I'm just here to share my heart and my thoughts about our dearly departed friend. Let us put our hearts and mind in the framework to receive the opening prayer. Amen. Father, let us bless you, my God, on this day. For this is the day that you have created all by yourself. You need no help of no one. But when you created this day, you had us in mind. And so therefore, Father, we come, O Lord, first of all, worshiping you and blessing your holy name. For we know that whatever you've created for eternity. And oh God, whatever transpires in this day, you are outside of creation, but it's you, O God, that still controls everything. And so now, O God, as we come in honor and in remembrance of our dearly departed brother, I just pray right now, O God, that you be glorified in all that is said and done. Help the folk, O God, help them to honor, O God, his legacy. And most importantly, O God, I pray by your spirit that you edify his family and his friends. That at the end of this day, we will truly say it was a beautiful day and a beautiful time to come together as brothers and sisters in you. Bless all these things, O God, and glorify yourself. That's in Jesus' name I ask and pray. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Reverend Graves. Much appreciated. Good morning, good afternoon, everyone. I'm Carlester's niece, Janelle, and I'm honored to be here today with my family. We're going to keep the program as brief as possible, but we sincerely appreciate you all coming out, respecting social distancing guidelines, and just fellowshipping with us today. Born to Charles and Evelyn Smith, Carlester was affectionately known by his family as Lessie. He was the youngest of 8 siblings: Rosemary, Charles Samuel, Robert, Roberta, Michael, Brenda, and Rhonda. Originally from Arnold, Maryland, the family relocated to Annapolis after a fire destroyed their home. Born with developmental disabilities, he completed his education at Central Special in Edgewater, Maryland. He was not hindered in any way by his family, nor did he impose limitations on himself. Over the years, speculations would come and go, but he was never hit by a car or beaten severely. He never sniffed chemicals or had a brother who was hit or had a brother who died in a car accident. He was simply different. Years ago, he was employed for several years at the former Holiday Inn Hotel in Annapolis. He held various jobs, played basketball, and participated in Special Olympics, but the duty dearest to him was navigating West Street and Fourth Drive on a daily basis until physical ailments stopped him. In earlier years, Richard Scher would come to Annapolis during a snowstorm to find him, idolizing his ability to weather all elements. Essentially, that is what brings us peace as a family. He was who he was, and he will always be. Up until he took his final breath, he had a smile on his face. As family, we made sure he was safe, that his needs were met, and he took care of the rest in his own way. While he was not a millionaire, his spirit is richer than any of us can imagine. We don't know why he chose to make it his daily mission to walk Annapolis and wave bags, but maybe it's not for us to understand. What we do know is that his world was something amazing, and he will be deeply missed by all. Next, we'll have family reflections, which we will need to limit to 6. I'd like to invite my uncle, Pastor Paul Gross, up to share some words, and then family can proceed.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you all for coming. And Carlester is loved by many, and he's like a, share with you what the scripture said. The scripture says that there's not one sparrow that falls to the ground without our Heavenly Father knowing of it. All of us, we live our lives, many of us live our lives as a sparrow. Sparrow that soars not very high and doesn't leave that far from the ground, but it lives its life, and for many, we're not known, or we never, you know, achieve the heights of an eagle. Carlester, he achieved that height. Carlester may have started off as an eagle, but he became a phenomenal. He became someone special just by walking the streets of Annapolis. Though his feet never left the ground, he soared high as an eagle. Many have seen him walking the streets. Many have watched him, and they realize that this man is someone different. He's more than just your average guy. In his love for his community, in his love for those around us, that he shared his love, and so many was impacted by. You can put it in front of the sign. So many people were affected by his smile, his wave, the things that he did. It became such a reflection of who he was. Amen. Carlester, he was well loved by all. Annapolis or Annapolitans, you have done your city well and all those that love him by allowing Carlester to live his life as the walking man, to live his life the way that he knew how to live. And you did not judge him for that, but loved him for that. This family loved you for loving him. And all the glory and all the honor goes to God for this man's life, Carlester Smith. Amen. God bless you.
Amen. Thank you.
Thank you, Uncle Paul. That just took my breath away. Anyone else from the family like to say a few words? Cousin Patricia Holliday.
Hello, everybody. He was my first cousin. My mom and his dad were sisters and brothers. And he just lost his last aunt on the 28th of December. But I'm just happy to be here. I loved him. I loved his life. I love who he was. He didn't have to be anything different. Not only did he walk these streets, but he cleaned these streets. He helped to keep Annapolis looking a lot better. He picked up little teeny pieces of paper that all of us out here probably would have walked over. And I just wanted everybody to know that I loved him. He was my cousin, and I was proud to be a part of his life.
My name is Michelle Graves, and I was Carlester's niece. I can't believe I'm doing this, but the love that I see that you all have shared with him, and the fact that you all loved him, not just us, we knew him. With your family, some of them you gotta love. But you all loved him. I'm so proud to see this, and my heart is so full right now. My heart is also full to see all my family. I thank God that we're here today. And God, get ready, because he's coming. I'm so happy to see everybody here to give him praise. I thank my aunts, my mom, my cousins, everybody that could come out, and we can gather also and remember him. For us to be together, for the city of Annapolis to be together, especially in times like these. Thank you, everyone. God bless you.
You know how your daughters are. Afternoon. I was awake 3 o'clock this morning, tossing and turning, and you know, Annapolis, it's a beautiful day, a beautiful celebration for my brother. I'm his sister, Brenda. Some of you might know me. I used to do the karaoke in the park, Whitmore Park. I've done lots of stuff. I'm on the board at the Anne Arundel General Hospital. My brother, Carlester. Baby boy, that's what he was. He will be missed. You know, it's like my niece say, it's one thing to be loved by your family, but when you're loved by the city of Annapolis, Australia, Nashville, Tennessee, I mean, we've had people pour out their heart from all over the world about my brother. And we really do love y'all from the bottom of our hearts. We truly do. Thank you so much.
Next, we'll open for condolences and well wishes from members of, from public officials. I'll call up first Delegate Shanika Henson.
Good I want to thank Carlester's family for sharing him with all of us and allowing us to share this experience with you and to celebrate his life. We understand that a person's history and their legacy is written by the words that are spoken after they have departed this earth. And so that's why we're here today, to heap the praise onto Carlester that he deserves, to heap the love onto your family that you all deserve. You are a testament and a reflection to how family cares for family. And the larger Annapolis family just wants to honor you for that and to remember him for his legacy. Carlester was a humble man who lived a humble life and even died gracefully and peacefully. And it's just a testament to who we are when we are our better selves here in Annapolis. You don't have to be an elected official or be a public person to be a person that people can celebrate and find value in your leadership. The way that Carlester took it upon himself to find his own place in the city, his own responsibility, his own contribution that he could make is something that each of us can learn from. And he did it in a way that was so selfless and so gracious. It was to give back to the city of Annapolis. So as we drive by this mural, as we look at the kind eyes that he had, as we look at the joy that was reflected in his face, we can all use it as a barometer to measure our own public service. Are we doing it with as much joy as Carlester did? Are we doing it from a place that's as selfless as Carlester did? He can forever be a reflection for us of what we strive to be when we're being the best that we can be in the city of Annapolis. So I thank you and I honor you as a family. We all can hope to have a family that will love and embrace us as much as you all did Carlester. Thank you.
Next, we'll have Alderwoman Sheila Finlayson.
Good morning. It is a beautiful day in the city of Annapolis. Sad day for all of us, but a beautiful day. I come to speak today instead of the mayor, who is out of town. You probably recall when this mural was created, the mayor was here and blessed this mural and has been a strong advocate for community leadership and community support. Carlester was part of the fabric of what makes Annapolis great. He shared with us himself. He walked the street, this very street of West Street, always with a smile on his face, doing a deed that some of us would not dare to want to do. Never once with a grimace or a foul word, but always that warm and gentle, comforting approach. And so we all mourn today. And I say it's a beautiful day because Carlester's in a better place now. He's earned his wings. You know, he's done his job on this earth. And now he's looking down at us with that beautiful smile on his face, saying thank you for paying attention, and we have. And so on behalf of Mayor Gavin Buckley and all the members of the Annapolis City Council, I present this City Council citation. And it reads, whereas a generation of Annapolis residents have witnessed the kindness of Carlester Smith, known as the walking man, as he smiled and waved to passersby and picked up trash on daily walks in the West Street corridor and parole community. And whereas Carlester was born in 1957 and grew up in the Oberg Court community in the city of Annapolis. And whereas Carlester Smith participated in Maryland Special Olympics as a young person, played basketball at the Stanton Center, and was an honorary member of the Tommy Tom Marching Band, where he would march during the city parades. And whereas Carlester Smith became a staple in the community as he cleaned parking lots, washed windows, and waved his trash bags on his daily expeditions. And whereas the walking man, Facebook page has more than 13,000 followers, showcasing the affection city residents have for Carlester Smith. And whereas Carlester, beloved by family, friends, and complete strangers, always had a smile to offer. And whereas Carlester was called home on Monday, March 1st, 2021. Now thereby, I, Mayor Gavin Buckley, Alderwoman Sheila Finlayson, do proclaim March 6, 2021 as Carlester Smith Day in the city of Annapolis.
Carlester Smith Day. My grandfather is smiling. I would like to also recognize Alderwoman, Rhonda Pendel Charles. Carlester's passing is a terrible loss to our community. In these times of divisiveness nationally and locally, Carlester was literally a walking example of how we should appreciate each other, a daily reminder of who we should be and how we should contribute to the positive quality of life for everyone. As a child, I vividly remember that the Smith family were longtime residents of Parole in Ward 3. Our families knew each other well for many decades. We all attended Parole Elementary School together. In fact, Carlester's brother Robert, who's here today, and I were partnered together as we marched into and out of our graduation ceremonies at Parole Elementary School in 1966. I would also, when I came here, I looked at that sign that said Loading Zone, Monday through Friday in the time. Carlester had an unloading zone. His unloading zone was West Street and Forest Drive, and it had no time periods between it. He unloaded everything imaginable, and like we've all said, things that we wouldn't even want to pick up. Never catching a disease or never having a problem, never getting hit by a car, as we've heard here today. So that sign and having this mural here and this celebration here is really reflective and prophetic as I see it. In honor of Carlester's life, I found this poem that I read at the mural dedication, and it's particularly relevant today, and it's entitled Keep Moving by Wilhelmina Stith. I scanned wise words in a book today. This was the message they seemed to say. Keep moving ahead. You can't stand still unless you really are very ill. For if you stop like an unwound clock, you're bound to suffer a fearful shock. For something will happen to give you a shake and say to your conscience, move on, awake. Keep moving ahead or your soul will die and beauty evade your heart and eye. No matter at all that your pace be slow, so long as you upward, upward go into a finer atmosphere where ideals live and visions clear. And goodness and God and truth have taken firm stand, and folks to folks stretch a loving hand. For this be the measure of our success, the measure of all life's happiness, just how well we have moved ahead along the same streets that he has tread. God bless you all. We love you. Next, we'll have a selection by my mom, his sister Brenda Williams.
I don't know about tomorrow. I just live from day to day, and I don't borrow from its sunshine, for its skies may turn to gray, and I don't worry about the future, for I know what Jesus said, and today he walks beside me, for he knows what lies ahead. Many things about tomorrow I don't seem to understand, but I know who holds tomorrow, and I know who holds my. No, I don't seem, no, I don't seem to understand, but I know who holds tomorrow, and I know he's holding my.
Next, we'll have a brief moment of reflection and silence as we play Walk Around Heaven.
The family would like to extend many thanks to the community of Annapolis, as well as the Annapolis City Police Department, the Mayor's Office, and members of the Annapolis City Council, as well as each and every individual who've reached out to share memories in kind words. We sincerely appreciate you. It may sound a bit naive, but I never saw this day coming. I just knew that Uncle Lessie would be around for years and years to come, but here we are. A coworker said to me yesterday, "Wow, what a great dash." And it reminded me of the poem, The Dash. If you don't mind, I'll share it. The Dash by Linda Ellis. I read of a man who stood to speak at the funeral of a friend. He referred to the dates of on her casket from beginning to end. He noted that first came the date of her birth and spoke of the following date with tears. But he said what mattered most of all was the dash between those years. For the dash represents all the time that she spent alive on earth. And now only those who loved her know what that little line is worth. For it matters not how much we own, the cars, the house, the cash. What matters is how we live and love and how we spend our dash. So think about this long and hard. Are there things you would like to change? For you never know how much time is left that can still be rearranged. If we could just slow down enough to consider what is true and real, and always try to remember the other way people feel, the way other people feel, and be less quick to anger and show appreciation more, and love the people in our lives like we have never loved before. If we treat each other with respect and more often wear a smile, remembering that the special dash might only last a little while. So when your eulogy is being read with your life's actions rehashed, would you be proud of the things they say about how you spent your dash? Yeah. Yeah. And I ask that you join me in a round of applause to my uncle on how he spent his dash. In closing, I'd like to say first to my family, job well done. While Lessie received his roses while he could smell them, I would like to give roses to a few special people. Specifically, my Aunt Rosemary. Anyone familiar with the task of a caretaker knows the stress, the isolation, and tiredness associated with it. But not once did you say no or complain when it came to him. And we just want to say thank you. Leave here a little more inspired to be good citizens, good family members, and good people to each other. When you think of all the horrendous things occurring in the world, how amazing is it that we could gather today and exchange positive energy and love for someone who touched us based on his happy spirit alone? We are surrounded by inspiring individuals on a daily basis. Take the time to sponge them in. Let their energy be contagious. We should all be reminded to be kinder, to extend ourselves where we can, and to provide support to those who we need most and who need us most. We're gonna close with the song Parting Ways by Cody Chestnut. This song was from the movie Soul on Disney, and it just, with so much loss throughout the past year, it's such a simple song, but it really reminds you that death is not the end. It's not final. It's final for us here, but it's eternal. So, can you play part? What you wanted to do? Thank you.
eyes again. If life is the foundation, if the purpose be to recycle life, I promise I'll bring us to one. Bleeding heart in the end now, though we are parting ways, we shall come around to touch eyes again. If love is the foundation, purpose be to recycle life, I promise you'll bring us to one. Bleeding heart in the end, may you be blessed with good drink and food, and may your tongue be covered with a garment of good news. Love's the foundation, purpose is to recycle life. This is how.
What's up, everybody? Harris Sakofa here, coming to you from Nashville, Tennessee. You know, I grew up in Annapolis. I still call it home. Matter of fact, it's about 10 years ago, I was living right off of West Street, a little black and white row house. And every couple of days, I'd see Carlester going on one of his walks. So it got me thinking, that man deserves a song. I mean, he's an Annapolis icon, we all know that. So I went ahead and wrote this song for him. It was like this.
Walking Lester walks on the same road every day. Most people here don't know his real name, but he's been walking for some time, cleaning up the town. He keeps moving on forward until he turns around, and he keeps on walking, walking on his way, swinging those plastic bags in his hands. Oh yes, he keeps on walking, walking on his way, picking up aluminum cans. Walking Lester sees as the cars create a breeze. Annapolis has changed in all these years, but one thing stays the same. Carlester is his name. Mr. Smith's deserving all our praise, and he keeps on walking, walking on his way, swinging those plastic bags in his hands. Oh yes, he keeps on walking, walking on his way, picking up aluminum cans. Yes, he keeps on walking.
Thank you.